next on Bally. Blooding Hockey is presented by BMW, the ultimate driving machine. Visit BMWTampaBay.com for exceptional offers. Welcome inside Scotiabank Arena. Here are your starting goaltenders tonight.
Andre Vasilevsky, game number 21. He's 13-4-3 with a .927 save percentage. He had a big win against Montreal on Tuesday. And Jack Campbell, game number 22, 14-4-2, .932 save percentage, 1.92 goals against. John Cooper, a depleted lineup, but he's going for his 400th win tonight.
And he's going to start the Belmar line, which is the only line that has not been changed up this evening, mainly because Anthony Cirelli out of the lineup this evening as Bunting skates back in for the Leafs and takes a shot that is wide. Anthony Cirelli day-to-day with an upper body injury. So a little line juggling for the coaching staff tonight. Here's Belmar, in over the line, stripped to the puck, picked up by Austin Matthews. Gets it to Bunting, and he snaps that puck in, but it is whistled down at the blue line.
Let's take a look at what happened to Anthony Cirelli, and your guess is as good as mine. Just the bad news is he can't play in this game. Yeah, the puck was coming at him. It hit him somewhere, it looked like, on the backside as he went down, maybe in the back, maybe in the ribs. Not quite sure. It was difficult to tell, but he is not in the lineup, and he is a huge loss for John Cooper, as he is Mr. Everything. Penalty kill, power play, and munching minutes, especially without Braden Point in the lineup.
He would normally be centering this line. It's on the ice right now. Leafs control the puck in the zone. There's a sharp angled shot from the corner from Nylander, and it ends up back in the line. Liljegren trying to center it in front, looking for Kerfoot. Goes in there for John Tavares, pops out in front for Bogosian, had a battle to get that puck to the line, and he does. Ross Colton is centering this line that would normally be centered by Cirelli. So Colton moves up. Leafs have their own injury issues. They got a couple of key guys out as well, most notably Mitch Marner, out 2 to 3 weeks. Here's a chance on the far side. Kasha with a shot, a save by Vasilevsky. Puck goes into the corner, centered out in front, and there is Stamkos to break that up. Taylor Radish, he's also been elevated. He's going to play on this line with Stamkos and Andre Palat to start. Centering pass out in front, but a penalty had been called as Morgan Rielly is slow to get up, and the Leafs, with a dangerous power player, going to go to work first.
Yeah, that was a dangerous fall into the boards there.
Number 16, Tampa Bay, 2 minutes tripping.
Taylor Radish on the forecheck, and he got the stick in the feet, I believe, of Morgan Rielly. He's trying to go up the puck, but he did lift that foot up just a tad, and this power play for the Toronto Maple Leafs goes at it. They are hot. 27% for the year, third overall, and they've got 6 power play goals just in their last 3 games.
Up against a very good penalty killing team, especially on the road. Leafs start with a puck. Rielly in the corner, banks it back to Nylander. Nylander back to Morgan Rielly. In towards the net, out in front for Tavares. He's tied up by Sergachev. Rebound, scores! Andrei Kasha finds the loose change, shovels it in, and it's 1-0 Toronto.
Well, you can see their efficiency level. Win the faceoff, that's where it starts. And this Toronto team is a machine in the faceoff circle. But look at how practical and simple this is. A pass down low, a one-touch pass from Kasha to John Tavares, which probably should have been a goal if it wasn't for Sergachev pushing him from behind. But then Kasha seemed to surprise Vasilevsky on the short side. Vasi looked over his shoulder like, lost my angle just a tad there. And Kasha's able to spoon that one in the top shelf. And these two teams, both of them, when they score first, they are dangerous. So Toronto with a big edge here.
That was just 13 seconds into their power play. 1-0 Leafs, 2 minutes into the hockey game. Number 20 for Tampa Bay, that is Rielly Nash, making his Tampa Bay debut. He's an 11-year veteran, just picked up this week off of waivers from the Winnipeg Jets. He will center a line with Gabriel Forche and Boris Kachuk. This one rolls in toward the Leaf net, and it's picked up by Brody. Brody to Rielly, and then up the ice to Kyle Clifford. Clifford checked by Ruda, and it comes free for Forche. Andre Kasha with his 7th goal of the season. He's off to a great start. Tampa Bay steps in, puts that puck into the corner. Here's Joseph now, back to the line for Foot. Off the end boards, they jam away the side of the net. That was Kalorn. Couldn't get into the goal, thought he was tripped at the back end of that play. Now it's Muzzin. Gets it to Wayne Simmons, and he'll dump that in.
Because of some of the injuries that they had, Toronto's dumping and chasing more than we've seen over the last year or so.
Here's a chance for a two-on-one, but on the back check was Austin Matthews taking it away from Matthew Joseph. So Matthews doing a lot of scoring, and nice back check on that play. Now he's got the puck. There's the wrist shot in on Vasilevskiy, and he's got it. No rebound.
Well, Sheldon Keefe, his team is marching right along this year. They can score all right, and they've got a hot power play. We've already seen that. He did not like their game against Columbus the other night, though. He said there wasn't a lot to like other than the score. They won. But they certainly have had, as you pointed out, their share of issues and some key ones. And so they're fighting through that as well. So they're going to be leaning on their big guys, especially up front, Matthews and Tavares, who are having great years.
Here's Nylander. Nylander makes one little move. And then it's sent back down the ice by McDonough, and this is going to be an icing call against the Lightning. Well, here's tonight's Taco Bell take.
The first key for the Lightning will be cycle. If they can spend time in the offensive zone, especially the way the Belmar line does, I think they can get Toronto running around at early speed. They've had some issues the last three or four games, I'd say at least, not getting off to good starts. Well, this one being down 1-0 was more about the power play of Toronto, but they need to move their feet early.
Roddy with a shot off a face-off win by the Leafs. They were a very good face-off team. Second in the NHL. This one's back down the ice. Back to retrieve it as Roddy kicks it back into the corner. Alexander Kerfoot gets it away from Pilat. Pilat out there in the forecheck. Here's Radish. Radish walks into the corner to Pilat. His shot didn't get all of it. And Campbell's got it. And hangs on.
It's going to be interesting to watch Taylor Radish playing on this top line with Stamkos and Pilat. I hope he's not intimidated by playing with him and overpasses, but look at the play he makes in the corner. Really good, solid stuff there. Turns the puck over from Kerfoot, an experienced forward. Hangs on, makes a nice little move. And who does he find? Andre Pilat. That one was rolling a little bit, a last-minute stick in there from the Toronto Maple Leafs. Otherwise, Andre Pilat could have had a great shot on that there. Good work by Radish. You know he wants to make up for that early penalty.
Which the Leafs cashed in on quickly. Sent back in by the Bolts. Here's Belmar and Maroon. Maroon sends it out in front, and it bounces around, and the Leafs are able to clear it. Nick Ritchie up ahead into the middle for Kasha. Kasha shot, and that just goes wide. Maybe Vasilevskiy got a tiny piece of that. Up high in the zone, David Camp back towards the net, and this one is scooped up by Vasilevskiy as Toronto's putting pucks to the net here.
We got a great matchup in goal here. Andre Vasilevskiy, another just great season again. He's got 13 wins on the season. The only guy with more is at the other end of the ice, and he's been quite a story too. Jack Campbell, who's got 14 wins, leads the way. Cam Talbot, Minnesota, also right up there. Shesterkin tied with Vasilevskiy. So, yeah, it's going to be a little tough to score here for both teams here tonight based on the stats.
Campbell's 10-2-1 at home. Lilligren takes a shot that goes off a leg. Picked out of the corner now by Simmons. Simmons back to the point. This is Christian Rubens, one of the recent call-ups for Toronto. His second NHL game. Big guy along the point, number 56. And he's going to go in after this puck. 6'5", 230 pounds. Boris Kachuk skates away, and they're going to call a hand pass, which caught Kachuk by surprise, and the faceoff's coming back.
Austin Matthews is the guy they're going to have to control. Matthews is on a roll after having wrist surgery in mid-August. He had a bit of a slow start, but boy, is he ever catching up. He's got 10 goals in the last 7 games. I was looking at his numbers at home here in this building, 72 goals in 83 games in his career. It is ridiculous.
Leading goal scorer from last season. And as you say, a 7-game goal-scoring streak. Here's Radish trying to force the issue. And he's caught up to by Muzzin. Puts it in back towards the net. Radish battling for it, so the rest of the Lightning. Stamkos can't contain. Hall's pass just missed the mark with Bunting. And now it's Radish again, right side, dumps it in. Into the corner goes Steven Stamkos. Excellent career numbers against the team he grew up watching as a kid. Matthews, little touch pass to the rookie Alex Steves, and Steves will leave it for Muzzin. Saucer pass near side for Steves, throws it out in front. Puck stays alive, sent it out in front. There's Radish. So break that up. Tips down the ice by Pallott. Moved across to Riley. And batted back in by Steves. He's the other guy that's been called up. This is also his second NHL game. Kalorn into the middle for Joseph. Joseph takes the puck wide. Little burst of speed, cuts back, throws it back to the line for Ruda. Ruda to Hedman. Hedman's wrist shot is right on. And Campbell's got it. He'll hang on, and we will take a break. With just under 14 minutes remaining here in the first period, the Leafs have scored first on the power play. Andre Kasha, 1-0, Toronto on Bally's. New face in the lineup, Brian. Here is tonight's Kia player profile.
There's Riley Nash. He's a 12-year pro, almost 600 games in the National Hockey League. This is his sixth team. Last year he went from Columbus to Toronto, and this year Winnipeg, now to Tampa Bay, because he's the kind of player that makes a good team really good. He's solid defensively. He's good on faceoffs. He's a penalty killer. He's got experience. He knows how to grab the game when it's getting away. He seemed to have trouble in Winnipeg. He couldn't get any offense going at all. He scored 15 goals a couple of years ago playing for Boston, but that's not what it's about for him. It's about accountability and reliability.
Puck turned over there by the Lightning, sent back in by Kalorn. Toronto banks it up the boards. Hedman holds his ground and then gets it back to Kalorn. Here's Ross Colton. Kind of toe picked a little bit as they try to release a shot. Now it's William Nylander, the overtime hero for Toronto the last time the Leafs and Lightning met in this building about a month ago. John Tavares, the Leaf captain, up to a great start to the season, much like the Lightning captain. And now it's Kalorn at center, and in the puck goes. Around the boards, it's going to be met over here by Belmar. Belmar shovels it back around. Into the corner goes Pat Maroon. Turn the puck over to Kasha, and he's taken off.
I wonder if somebody called his name there, maybe Kasha, and it sounded familiar to him. I'm not sure, because he just passed that one without looking right onto Kasha's stick. Usually Maroon's very patient with the puck in the corner.
It's the oldest trick in the book.
Yeah, worked.
Slap shot, sharp angle, and Vasilevsky makes the save there on Kasha. Backed up ahead. Here comes Corey Perry, who's in a hot stick of late. Really starting to heat up offensively. Big goal for him in Montreal in their last win on Tuesday night. Camp inside to Richie. Richie can't get it towards the net. Toronto gets back on the puck. There's Camp with a shot, and that is blocked. Shots right now are 5-2 in favor of Toronto. David Camp cuts back in his man. He's being watched down low there by Foote. In comes Belmar to try to help out. Now it's Simmons and Perry. Perry drives the puck free, and Sergachev has got it down. Lightning settles things down as they complete a line change on the fly. Both benches too. This one's turned over to Matthews. Wrong guy to have walk into one, and he stepped into that one with a slap shot, and Vasilevsky's got it.
Jeff Halpern's seen a lot over the course of his playing career and his assistant coaching career. He had great compliments for Corey Perry the other day. He said Corey Perry, his vision and his skills with the puck are among the best I've ever seen. Jagr, Kucherov, players like that, because of the way he can hold on, move the puck, and create space and time for other players that he's playing with. That's quite a compliment.
Here's a quick shot, rebound, Vasilevsky down, and it is not out.
Oh, wow.
Net. It was hopping around. Vasilevsky was down. He got a whole bunch of help. There were bodies everywhere, and the puck stays out.
I think it's Zach Bogosian was able to get a handle on it off the back of the foot of Vasilevsky. Yeah, and it's Bogosian. Well, some big-time help, of course, from Ryan McDonagh as well, because he played a little defensive football right in the crease area. Watch McDonagh get up here and do a real good job of taking his man out of the play, and then it's Bogosian who's whacking away at the puck. So if McDonagh doesn't take Michael Bunting out of the way, this one's probably in. Off the back of the foot, it's going in. and the Lightning are able to find a way to keep it up. But Toronto really buzzing here. The Lightning have to get themselves under control.
Matthews dancing around with a puck off the draw. Ross Colton with the outlet pass, missed a mark, too hot to handle for Killorn, and this one's going to be an icing call now against Tampa Bay.
Yeah, early in first periods has been an issue for the Lightning, and they've given too much momentum to too many teams. It happened in Boston the beginning of the trip, it happened in Philadelphia in the second game, and it happened the other night in the third game as well too. But at the same time, they've won the game, so it's not how you start, how you finish. But it'll be nicer to start a little better.
Toronto has now won 9 of the 12 faceoffs so far in this game. We knew this was going to be an issue, especially with Cirelli not here tonight, not in the lineup. Quick shot, save again by Vasilevskiy. That one on Riley. Here's tonight's Papa John's key ingredients.
Let's take a look at Toronto's season and what they've been doing. They've been winning a lot of games, and it's because of things like this. Tied for first in wins, goals against per game, very good. That's a big change for them. It's something they've been working on. Power play is absolutely outstanding. And the faceoffs, as you said, Dave, as a team, 54%. John Tavares leads the way with almost 59% in the faceoff circle.
Yeah, one of the top faceoff guys right now in the NHL. Liljegren back for Toronto, being forced back there by Tkachuk. Bruno quickly back up ahead to Boris Tkachuk, and in he goes. Riley Nash up there in the forecheck. Forecheck gets it back to Bruno. His shot is blocked right in front by Steves, and Banks back out to center. Nash sends it in. Along the side boards there, Tkachuk reaching for this one, goes back into the corner for Liljegren, and he'll sweep it around to Christian Rubens. Nearing the midway point of this first period, just one goal on the board, a lot of chances for the Leafs. Out shooting Tampa Bay now 9-2. Muzzin makes one little move, trying to cross ice pass, and it's cut off by Perry. Perry back the other way, left side into the middle, tip, scores! What a tip by Pierre-Edouard Belmar. He has tied this game.
What a play by Corey Perry. Perry saw what was coming at him at his own blue line. He'll put the brakes on. He's the one that stops the rush for the Toronto Maple Leafs. And then calmly just heads up the wing. That's where he stole the puck. Now watch this area pass. How about that for touch? That is perfection. Belmar just has to get inside position on his man backchecking Kerfoot, and he does so. It's right there, it's on the backhand. You just make sure you get it on the net. And Campbell can't quite get over on that short side quick enough. What a great job there by Corey Perry.
So Perry gets another assist. It's now 10 points in his last 10 games. And that line, Brian, they now have a total of 12 goals between the three of them. Perry, Belmar, and Maroon.
Scoring from the bottom six forwards, that's what we were talking about earlier in the year. It wasn't there, now it is.
So the Lightning even things up here just near the midway point of the first period. On the goal by Belmar, 1-1. Steven Stamkos into the middle for Foot. Foot's pass intercepted. Following up, though, is Palat, centers it to Radish, and he just fired it wide. Here's Sergachev on the drive. That's blocked as Tampa Bay's pushing right back. What a chance that was for Taylor Radish from nearby Caledon, Ontario. Not very far from here at all, about 30, 40 minutes. Riley settles the puck down, turns back up the ice at center, and then just lifts the puck in. Goes in after it against Colton. Riley centers it out in front, and there's Killorn. Leaves it for Joseph, and Matthew Joseph takes off. He'll cut across the left side. Joseph in, sweeps it back in front for Hedman. And Hedman was in too tight, but a penalty call coming up against Toronto. Touched up, and the call is going to be made. It's going to be a slashing call against the Leafs, and the Lightning will get a power play as Simmons heads to the box. So things get interesting here in the first period after Belmar has tied it up 1-1.
It's for slashing on the last shift out. Taylor Radish with a great scoring chance. The Stamkos line working her way through. Palat doing a nice job of controlling the puck and then throwing it into the slot area. And Radish is going to end up with a chance on net. This is the shift before that where it was Victor Hedman with some puck possession too, which ended up leading to the penalty. There's the finish of the Radish shot that just went wide on the far side. Too bad, because he was right in prime real estate.
So Toyota power play, first of the night for the Lightning. They went 0-3 Tuesday against the Montreal Canadiens. 0-1 in this building back on November 4th. Chance to take the lead. Hedman starts up the ice after the first clear by the Leafs penalty killers. Dumps it in. Palat gets up on the puck in the end boards. Kalorn is there as well. And Radish put on this number one power play unit. As they continue to juggle the personnel. Here's Palat now. Settles the puck down. Back up top to Hedman. Palat into the middle for Radish. And the rebound goes just wide for Kalorn. Just missed. Alex Kalorn. To Palat. Hedman now. Stamkos fakes the shot, pulls it back. They're watching him real close. Good effort there by Kasha to get it out. Not deep though. Tampa Bay will step right back in. Near side here is Victor Hedman. Leaves it in tight quarters for Kalorn. Kalorn lost the handle. Partially deflected. Here's a shot. Scores! Steven Stamkos with a rip job to the top shelf. And the Lightning take the lead, 2-1.
There is no way Campbell even saw this one. It was invisible. I'm not even sure the puck was lying flat. But the Lightning do a nice job of literally fighting the puck over the blue line. And then Stammer gets it back to in the middle of the ice. This is not his office, but does this lie flat? No, it doesn't. But did he ever catch that one? And look at Campbell. Campbell's going to go down and go, okay, I see you there. But I can't see that puck. His shoulder's going up, and that puck's already coming back off the twine, back and hitting him in the back of the leg. So Steven Stamkos, who always shines in this building, is always good against Toronto. I think maybe it has something to do with his hometown. Could be a little bit. Friends and family watching, etc. He came in with 49 points in 42 career games against the Leafs.
Yep.
Add another one.
That is number 50 against the Leafs in 43 games. His 21st goal against the Maple Leafs. And he's given the Lightning the lead here. 2-1. Here's a chance there for Michael Bunting. Bunting has been a real find for the Leafs here. Free agent signing. He comes home to play from Scarborough. Into the corner goes for Belmar. One of the goal scorers tonight for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Maroon checked there by Brody. It's moved back to the point there for McDonough. Here's Bogosian with a shot and a save made by Campbell. Chipped down the ice by Simmons. Bunting is up there against Bogosian, the former Toronto Maple Leaf. Belmar. At his own blue line, up ahead to Maroon, and back in it goes.
Boy, really changed the tempo and the momentum of the game. Toronto looked like they were flying. They took the 1-0 lead on that power play, had some two or three other scoring chances. Now the Lightning turned it around fast.
Puck is turned over again by Forche. He got it up to Nash, and they go right back to work. Riley Nash up there with Gabriel Forche. Could shoot with a big hit along the end boards. Puck comes free, hops around in the front of the net. To the line, knocked down by Foot. Back into the corner goes. Kachuk battles, so does Forche. They get it to Nash. Nash reaching for that loose puck, and now it's centered by Tavares, and Nylander cuts back.
Liljegren's really going to remember Kachuk. Did he ever throw him down in the corner hard?
Big night for Boris Kachuk. His first game in Toronto. He's from Waterloo, Ontario. He did not play the game back on November 4th. Radish did. Here's Palat trying to make a move and cannot. Now Radish has got it. Across to Stamkos. Stamkos with a shot saved by Campbell. And it's settled down by Steves. Steves goes to the backhand, lifts this one down the ice. Clifford can't get there first. Now it's Palat. Here comes Hedman now stepping in. Hedman, Stamkos with a drive, and Campbell has got that one. Another rocket from the Lightning captain. Campbell makes the save, but it is Steven Stamkos with his shot that has made it 2-1 in the first period.
chances, and the Lightning are starting to roll. Watch the last sequence here. There's Victor Hedman gets caught in the zone, but look at Ruda come back hard, make a diagonal pass. Beautiful play there by Palat, right to Victor Hedman, who's now looping through the neutral zone over to Steven Stamkos for the one-timer. That is outstanding. One of the overlooked things about Jan Ruda is because he looks after Victor Hedman. Victor can be aggressive. He can stand in there. It doesn't always work. But Ruda going back for a puck, making a pass like that, and starting the rush, that was outstanding.
And that pairing back out there on the ice. And you are right, Brian. This game really turned around with that, especially with that goal by Belmar. It has been all Tampa Bay since. And it's going to be an icing call. And now a word from Suncoast Credit Union.
My friends told me about Suncoast Credit Union and how they offer the lowest loan rates around. I applied from their mobile banking app. Who knew that buying a new car could be so easy?
Yeah, Sheldon Keefe's not going to be too happy with the last two goals that were scored. He said we had problems in the neutral zone at our blue line and net front in that game against Columbus, even though we won. So he was harping on it early on this morning. You know their meetings would have been full of it. But right now, on the rush, that Belmar goal and then Stamkos getting free in the upper slot. You won't like that one much either.
Loaded up line here after that offensive zone draw. He put out there Tavares and Nylander and Matthews. They got a faceoff win, and then Nylander knocked it all the way down the ice, and this shift has kind of gone nowhere for them.
Yeah, he's trying to change the momentum because, as we said, it really has shifted in favor of the Tampa Bay Lightning. With Nylander out there, yeah, they're going to make a line change now. But Matthews and Tavares and Nylander, yeah, they're really missing Mitch Marner, of course, who was a machine at puck control. And he's huge with Austin Matthews as well. So they're missing him because of that. Matthews, I expect, will have the puck on his stick a lot. If he gets any room out there, he will continue to hold it. He's playing with two wingers in Simmons and Bunting that are basically dump and chase guys. So it'll be interesting to see whether they have to dump and chase more or whether Matthews can get enough room and have the puck on his stick, as he is a machine.
Faceoff win by Radish, ends up back in the line for McDonough. His shot goes just wide. Bogosian in the corner. Down low now, it is Taylor Radish. Works that one into the corner up top for Stamkos. Stamkos, his shot. And it's deflected and pulled down by Matthews. Lead pass up ahead to Bunting. He's going to try to catch up to it and can't. Diving play there by Bogosian. Simmons throws that one out in front. Ends up back in the corner for Ryan McDonough. His clearing attempt, second ever, gets out. Stamkos checks Bunting, separates him from the pocket. It's lifted back out to center. Muzzin sweeps it near side for Austin Matthews. Matthews leaves this one for Rubens. There's a long-range shot, knocked out. Puck is loose, and it's batted wide by Simmons. Here's Matthews in front, and he was looking for Bunting. Another drive saved by Vasilevsky. Now the Leafs are pushing back hard. That shot goes high. Liljegren missed. This has been their best shift in a while. Back to the point. Matthews fans on that one, and the outlet goes to Belmar. Nylander can't advance the puck. Forced back now by Pierre-Edouard Belmar. Perry follows up. Perry and Belmar hooking up on a goal earlier in this period. Maroon had his man all tangled up, goes into the corner. Tavares is down there. And Perry has got the puck. Try to slide it to Maroon, and now the Leafs take over. Here comes John Tavares. At center, leaves it for Nylander. Back across, Kerfoot trying to one-touch. In tight, too tight, they try to center it back. And nobody home except for Maroon. Under 3 minutes to play. 2-1 Tampa Bay. Back-to-back unanswered goals by the Lightning. Morgan Rielly picks his way to the zone. He's been red hot as well. Several Leafs have on this impressive 20-game run for both of these teams, actually. They've been hot. Engvall racing up there. Ruda got the puck away from him. Now it's Borje. Borje's checked hard. And Hedman scoops up the puck and takes off. Victor Hedman angled away there by Engvall. Steves into the middle for Kyle Clifford. Clifford, recently reacquired by Toronto. And back to the point it goes. Justin Hall walks the line, dishes off. Leaves it for Engvall. His shot blocked in front of Vasilevsky. Puck along the side boards, and it's chipped up and out by Colton.
Nice job by Colton. Relieved the pressure. Got to go a little bit deeper. The Lightning badly needed a line change.
And the puck is quickly moved back inside the blue line. Now it goes to the open side. Killorn races after it against Justin Hall. Killorn. Puck comes out in front, and it's knocked away by Joseph. Now back up ahead, just out of the reach of Killorn. Knocked back in by Kasha. Backing up there was Foote up to center. Little back pass by Joseph. Does not make it past Muzzin. And back in it goes. Here's Joseph again. Hard bank off the boards. Backing up is Liljegren. Stamkos forces the puck to be moved. He does. Simmons had the puck get away from him. Now it's shoveled out in front. And Stamkos checked there by Brody. And Stamkos is going to get a penalty here for cross-checking. And it will be another Toronto power play as the Lightning captain is headed to the box.
Tampa Bay, number 91, minor penalty cross-check.
Referee was waiting for Stammer's few choice words before he made the announcement. There's a cross-check. Stammer didn't think it was much, but of course there has been a crackdown on the cross-checking. The Lightning badly need a good penalty kill here. Less than a minute to go here in the first.
Toronto scored 13 seconds into their first power play. Here's Matthews in front, and the tip by Tavares was blocked. Nylander chips that back to Riley, across to Matthews. Austin Matthews carries that puck into the corner, being watched by Killorn. Back up top is Riley. Half a minute to go of the period. William Nylander, his shot off of Ruda, rolls in towards the side of the net and away from Vasilevsky, and Riley Nash calmly made the play, and the Lightning get the clear.
Over the last year or so, we've seen Austin Matthews on different sides. He's been mostly, once they get set up, on the right side this year, which he was on that shift. Remember last year a lot, we saw him a lefty on that left side, as the Lightning do a good job of standing up at the blue line here, and they turn that one over.
Well, stay tuned for your local Honda dealer's first intermission report. Here's what's coming up. Paul Kennedy and Bobby the Chief Taylor are standing by in the studio. They will have an interview with that guy, Riley Nash, in his Lightning debut. U.S. Hall of Fame inductions for the Hockey Hall of Fame there, and highlights and stats, of course, from the opening 20 here in downtown Toronto. Last regular season meeting, sorry, Brian, of the season between these two here.
Austin Matthews, you got to worry about what a face-off win that is, and you got Tavares right in front of the net.
Nylander scores, just swings in that one. It's a CI shot, and with 6.4 seconds on the clock, the Leafs have tied it.
Vasilevsky had his field of vision taken away on this one. He doesn't even move. This is a shot from well out, but it's all about the motion that passes in front of the goaltender's eyes. What does Vasilevsky see? Nothing really. It's a total eclipse from Victor Hedman. Victor's in front of him, but then Victor will pivot out of the way. Watch Victor. Oh, can't quite see it there. Maybe you can. He pivots and turns away, and as soon as he does it, he knows that he's kind of betrayed his goaltender. Vasilevsky was looking at the back of 77. He's in good position, but the shot is perfect. It's up over his shoulder. He would have had a chance to make that save had he seen it coming.
And there's the horn. So one of those last minute goals ties this game on the power play. Toronto Maple Leafs capitalize on a late power play, and it's 2-2 through 20. One big area we knew we would miss Anthony Cirelli tonight is faceoffs, and we're seeing that so far.
Yeah, the Leafs are really taking it to the Lightning, and both the goals that were scored by the Toronto Maple Leafs were a result of faceoff wins by them. So the Lightning are going to have to bear down and have to plan on losing some faceoffs. Make sure you know who you have. This is the first one, and yeah, it was a power play, but Toronto never lost possession of the puck, and it ends up in the back of the net. John Tavares is their best. He was 6 out of 7. So if you're going to lose it, then make sure you know. Like Matthews really fooled them there, threw it across the ice, and this was the second goal late in that first period. So plan on losing them, especially if you're out there against Tavares. It is what it is sometimes. If you can't beat him, then figure out another way to equalize the situation. Tavares has always been one of the best in the league in that department. A Southern Ford key stats shows you the shots on goal. The Leafs started with that advantage early on. They had the puck in the zone an awful lot, and the Lightning were able to come back and really get their game going after the fact. And that Steven Stamkos goal was a beauty. That was a power play goal with some nice work along the wall by Alex Killorn, who didn't get an assist on that, but I thought he should have for the work he put in to keep the play alive.
Yeah, I would agree. Right now it's listed as unassisted. We'll see if anything's added later, but right now it's just Stamkos with his 13th, followed by Nylander and his 12th, and it's 2-2 as we begin the second period. In over the line, Perry drops it off for Belmar. Belmar looks back to the point, gets it to Perry, fans on the shot, and then lost his footing, and it's lifted back up and out by Matthews. Simmons will reset. That pass gets away, and skating into this one is Perry. Perry spun around just as he dumps the puck in to the Toronto zone. These two teams will not meet again until April. Both meetings remaining at Amalie Arena. Stamkos to the line, that is tipped just wide. McDonough gathers up the puck. That was Radish right in front, just missed. He's still there. That rebound is caromed right to Matthews. Muzzin just inside the Lightning blue line. Andre Palat warts the puck across to Bogosian. And this one's lobbed down. Jake Muzzin puts that into the corner, and goes Andre Palat. He is stripped of the puck by Tavares, and then turns the puck over to Sergachev, and back in it goes. Tavares can't contain it along the wall. It's worked back to the line. Here's Foot to Sergachev. Sergachev forced back, keeps the puck in, but gave it away to Tavares, and he's straight up the middle of the ice. Leaves it back for Kerfoot. Puck comes around the boards, picked up in the corner there by Sergachev, and moved out by Foot. Here's Kerfoot again. Lost the handle, and Sergachev says thanks, I'll take that. And he moves it quickly up to Colton. Colton drops it off and couldn't find Colton. His intended target, Matthew Joseph. Back comes Riley. Riley shot across the goal mouth. Nobody home for the Leafs. Brody slaps that one in. That catches some of the netting, and we get a whistle.
Taylor Radish has had some great looks at the net already in this game. He just missed by a whisker in the first period, shooting a little wide. But watch number 16 fighting for position in front. He got his stick on that one, redirected it, and it just trickled by the outside of the post again. He consistently does that. We're seeing every night now where he gets into the scoring areas at the right time. You have to fight your way through sometimes. Sometimes you just have to sort of linger in those soft areas. He's starting to figure out all those different situations. Radish gets chances consistently.
Two goals in his last three. Puck battle off the draw. Nick Ritchie, who scored in the last game for the Leafs, his first goal this season. Can't get it towards the net. Puck stays in the corner. Killorn's in there. And now Hedman settles the puck down, gets it to Ruda. And back down the ice. Liljegren back to get it for Toronto, banks it up ahead. This one bounces right to the Lightning, and it's worked across. Ruda moves that one ahead, off the stick of Killorn, and back in. Nick Ritchie, checked there by McDonough, slapped off his stick. And there's Riley Nash. McDonough at center. Finds the target opposite side. It's Killorn. Drops it back for McDonough. Up top, here's Bogosian with a shot. And Campbell's got that. No rebound.
Oh, some excellent movement there in the offensive zone. The Lightning exchanging positions, moving around everybody. It's hard to tell the D-men from the forwards. Watch McDonough come across to the opposite side of the ice from his left defense position. Bogosian realizes, well, the soft area then, the open area, is where McDonough just came from. And so a nice, really set up there. Bogosian with the one-timer. There was nobody in front, but the crisscrossing and moving the puck, using the width of the ice well in the offensive zone is something the Lightning have done consistently well this year.
J. Justin Hall turns the puck over to Kachuk, and Kachuk's going to go for the net. Takes a shot, gets his own rebound. Wrap around, and he just put it right through the crease. On a great effort by Boris Kachuk. With no doubt all kinds of friends and family in the stands here tonight. He comes close. That pass gets away. McDonough back up to Kachuk. Onto the backhand and inside the blue line. Hall to Tavares. Nylander tied up just a little bit, and they are going to call this icing.
Boris Kachuk is on the puck all the time in the offensive zone, and this one is an excellent play. He just can't quite finish it. He keeps the play alive, gets his own rebound, and then tries to spin around, and he goes right through the crease. Can't quite take that extra, probably another foot of ice he needed to take. Barb Underhill, their power skating coach, I think next time she's in town with him, she'll work with him to open those feet up a little bit more and give him that chance to get his stick in front while he's under control with his feet.
Thrown across the ice, and now here comes Stamkos with numbers. Stamkos across, Palat, shot, scores! Andre Palat takes the pass, buries it, and the Lightning have the lead back.
Excellent work by this line. They've been really good on the rush. They made some great chances in the first period. Taylor Radish had that great chance, but Andre Palat will cash this one in. A bouncing puck at Stamkos, who has really had a lot of flow to his game already, and it is the 3-on-2. And actually, Palat, I thought at first Radish had this goal because Palat's trying to pass it to Radish, and it's put in actually by Nylander, who's back-checking. Number 88 did a good job of seeing what Palat wanted to do, but it didn't turn out helping very much as it went five-hole in his old goaltender.
And it is 3-2 for the Lightning on the goal by Palat. And after a long goal drought for Andre Palat, no goals in 10, he has really started to pick up the pace. Four goals in his last five games now.
And it looked during that streak, that bad streak, Dave, he just wasn't getting very many looks.
Here's Riley with the puck for the Leafs in behind the Lightning net. Engvall back into the corner. Riley is checked there by Cal Foote. Both guys go down. Belmar protects the puck and then got it away to Sergachev. Lifted back down, and racing after it is Pat Maroon. So for Palat, that is his eighth goal of the season. Goals in back-to-back games. He got the game winner late. Here's Joseph with a shot, and that goes over the crossbar. Riley settles things down. Out in front, save made by Campbell on Alex Killorn, as this line was causing all kinds of problems for the Leafs.
Well, that's the kind of cycling I was talking about on the keys to the game. Lightning do a nice job on this one. Alex Killorn has a few words with Simmons. Simmons didn't like the fact that Killorn will come in afterwards and jam at that puck while the goaltender has it. Simmons is one of their tougher guys and certainly sends messages whenever he gets the chance. But look at Colton and Joseph doing a really nice job there in tandem, turning the puck over before Killorn and Simmons end up having words. Alex Killorn, yeah, I thought he should have had an assist on the Stamkos goal, but as you said, Dave, maybe they'll give it back to him upon review as the game moves along here.
That happens. Right now on the NHL website, they're saying that Palat's goal is unassisted, and that's not the case.
Killorn hasn't gone more than two games in a row without a point all season long. That's terrific stuff.
Another faceoff win for the Leafs, but they turn that puck over. Here's Palat. Trying to corral that puck. Kasha almost raced away, but it's batted away from him by Jan Ruda. And that is offside at the blue line.
John Cooper was asked about the key to winning these games just of late, especially on this road trip. And he said, really, it's our goals against. The last four games, they've given up 2, 1, 2, and 2. Those are magic numbers. A lot of times in the NHL, it's a race to three goals as to who's going to win games. Now, it's still fairly early on in the season. We've seen quite a few goals being scored around the NHL, but the Lightning are at two goals against already, and they would like to hold it at that point. Their game has certainly gotten better and better, and you like the way they've started out in this second period.
Andre Vasilevsky has allowed two or less in 12 of his last 15 starts. Back to the line. Hedman moves it across to Ruta. Wrist shot on the way. That's blocked. Gets it right back. Another wrister. That's blocked too. And it goes into the corner. Bunting. Trying to dig that one out for Matthews on the fly. And now Bunting up ahead. He's got Simmons up in this rush. Leaves it for Matthews. And he's checked there by Hedman. Michael Bunting to Wayne Simmons. Simmons lugs that puck and then feeds the point. Swept across. Hall's shot. Caught and held by Vasilevsky. Just under 14 minutes remaining here in the second period, and Andre Palat has scored to give Tampa Bay another one-goal lead on the road in Toronto on Bally.
Tonight, he scored a goal in the first period, and we'll see exactly where he was. 38 feet out from the net after a nice turnover by Killorn to keep the play alive. 88 mile an hour slap shot on a rolling puck. I mean, he caught this one just clean. And sometimes those pucks will sail. See, it wasn't flat, but he's got so much experience and so much just pure instinct when it comes to hitting rolling pucks. It's amazing.
And they have now added an assist to Stamkos on the Palat goal, so that's official. So he's got one and one tonight. Another face-off. Tavares pulls that back to the line for Brody. Brody works that one across. Morgan Riley in towards the net, and Vasilevsky squeezes that puck. With Tavares looking for anything loose in front.
Yeah, face-off win, and Morgan Riley, who has an assist in the first period, comes in and he's hot too. He is a very smart defenseman. He's on the move right side of your screen. He's just going to feed this in to players that are moving there. Riley had four assists against Columbus last game and three assists the game before against Minnesota. So 7 points in two games, 1 point again here tonight. Don't give Morgan Riley too many chances or too much room moving in from the blue line.
Tavares, Matthews, and Nylander remain out there for these offensive zone draws. And Tavares is putting on a clinic this evening in the faceoff dot. Riley jumps on that loose puck. Here's Nylander. Digs it out, gets it right back from Tavares. William Nylander cuts back on Stamkos, still with a puck, kicks it back to the line. Riley, Brody had to settle that puck down and sweeps it down low. Left for Nylander. Given a little bit of a shove there by Stamkos. Forces him around the edge. Left for Tavares. In front, knocked down. And cleared back to the line. Not out. Brody loads, shoots. Nylander wise, shoots, and a save made by Vasilevsky.
Boy, that was prime real estate for Nylander, who has a goal in this game already from well out and from distance and off to the side. That was right down the throat, and Vasilevsky beat him.
What a sequence that was, that whole 30 seconds. 13 minutes to go. Andre Palat has given the Lightning the lead here in the second period. Second one-goal lead they've had tonight. David Kampf stripped of the puck by Joseph. And Joseph works it across to Sergachev off his skates. Rolls back for Cal Foot. Up the boards, chopping at that one is Colton. He's forced back. This one goes into the corner for Kasha. Kasha's got a goal tonight on the power play for Toronto. Here's Kampf with a shot and a save made again by the glove of Andre Vasilevsky.
Turnover coming off the wall there caused a scoring chance for Toronto. And let's go back to the Nylander chance. He is right down the throat at Vasilevsky. Top of your screen, off of a rebound. There he comes. And Vassy, moving to his left, is able to use that blocker to the right. And the Lightning like to use the middle of the ice when they're coming out of their zone. And when it goes wrong, it's immediate scoring chance. It's the same thing for everybody around the league, all the different teams, I mean. Sometimes the only way to come out is up the middle. But you have to be precise. It's got to be tape to tape, or you're eating it.
Corey Perry. Into the near corner for Hedman. Hedman trying to go up the middle there, and they turned it over to Matthews, and his shot is snared by Vasilevsky.
Well, that was quite a battle for a puck as the Lightning were making a play coming out of their zone, and Belmar will bump into Austin Matthews. He got the worst of that one, but Matthews is I mean, he's a big, heavy guy. He can play a heavy game, and he is fast on his feet. Look at that. It doesn't even knock him down. Belmar, I think, knew he was there, but he was trying to play the puck in the air. Belmar went right to the bench after that. He is back now, so apparently wasn't shaken up, but it turned into a scoring chance for Austin Matthews. You don't want that to happen too often.
And now Belmar will square off with a faceoff dot against Matthews, and he's waved out, so in comes Maroon. Pulled back by Matthews. Liljegren jumps on the puck, takes a sharp angle shot up high, and Vasilevskiy made that stop and batted the loose puck away. Knocked down at center by Matthews. Simmons sends it right back in for Toronto. They're making a considerable push after the Palat goal. Centered out in front, trying to find Matthews. Here's a drive, and that goes wide. Liljegren. Michael Bunting trying to cut back on Hedman, leaves it for Matthews. Matthews banks it hard off the boards, and behind the net is Engvall. Picked up by Ruta, and up and down it goes. And that is going to be icing against Tampa Bay. Your Tampa Bay area BMW centers want to remind you to tune into Bally Sports Saturday afternoon as the Lightning travel to Ottawa to face the Senators. Coverage begins, note the early time, 12:30 with Lightning Live. Pregame Saturday, Bolts, Senators, the last of this five-game road trip right here on Bally Sports. A road trip that they are a perfect 3-0 on so far. Quick shot saved by Vasilevskiy. Puck is steered in by Maroon, and we'll get another faceoff.
That's probably the third or fourth time that Toronto has taken some shots from really bad angles and just thrown it right into Vasilevskiy's feet. Just get it right into the crease. I think maybe they're just trying to get people away from the puck to go to the net to consistently shoot. But we have seen him, and he's been sharp. He hasn't left the near side post. In which case it would be a very dangerous situation for him. But Toronto continues to take those shots from bad angles.
Good battle there by Ross Colton against Tavares. Well, they turn the puck over. Kerfoot in the corner. Back to the point. That's Nylander. Here's a shot from Rubens. Got a good piece of that. Another drive, and it's deflected off the stick of Colton and out of play.
Lightning not sorting it out real well here, but Toronto really on the puck, doing a nice job of making some plays and being patient as well, too. They're using that deep slot as well. There's another good look of using the top area of the zone in order to create some scoring chances, get some pucks in the net, and try to have their guys away from the puck go there at the same time.
Another face-off win against Tavares, that one by Stamkos. Bag pass just missed Stamkos, otherwise he was gone. TJ Brody, in comes Palat, forcing him, they force the turnover. Stamkos out in front, Radish scores! Taylor Radish picks the top corner. Welcome home, kid. It is 4-2 Tampa Bay.
He'll get a big rush out of this, scoring coming home, but he's really starting to feel it. This young man has terrific hands, and he showed it there. Missed by a whisker in the first period, but watch Palat get in on the forecheck right there. Just the fear factor alone scaring that puck up in Steven Stamkos, who's having a whale of a game. Coming right in on the heels of Palat. Watch that for a little area pass. And Palat is aware enough to leave this puck alone. He doesn't fight for it. He realizes it's not for him. And Taylor Radish makes the perfect shot. Nice pivot, and he just spoons it right upstairs under the bar. What a shot.
And it was the forecheck pressure by Palat that caused that whole turnover to happen in the first place. So this line getting it done. And as you mentioned, Steven Stamkos now with 3 points at the midway point of this game. What a season he is having. And here he comes again. Stamkos in over the line. Stops up, try to beat foot, but he is double teamed. This one goes high up in the air, lands at the center ice logo there, and the Leafs have it at the blue line. Tampa Bay opens up a 2-goal lead here in Toronto. 4 goals on 14 shots against Jack Campbell, who has been very stingy for like 2 months.
Well, a couple of these shots, what's he going to do? The Stammer shot was a laser beam top shell, and so was that shot just a moment ago by Radish.
Foot in the corner. Heels back as the Leafs make a change. Past the midway point of the second period. Goals here in the second by Palat and Radish. Leafs come back in. Engvall on his back end. Try to curl back, puts it back in the corner. Puck gets trapped along the sideboard. Steves is there for Toronto, and now Liljegren puts this one across. Here's Muzzin with a drive, and that hits Vasilevsky. He directs a little traffic, and the Lightning put it down the ice with just enough weight. They make the change. Leafs work the puck up the ice. Batted away at the blue line. Forshay forces Muzzin to dump it in, and he does.
Nice recovery by the Lightning right at their own blue line. It was a line change, and that was Kyle Clifford on the long pass trying to sneak in up the middle. Lightning closed the door.
Rubens, he's got Colton all over him. Turn the puck over again. Killorn trying to get that to sit down, and he takes a shot. It's deflected. Joseph to the line. And the Leafs take over. Here comes Matthews with a lead pass to Bunting. Bunting is in. Vasilevsky looks behind him, and he's got the puck as it just squeezed through, but Vasilevsky recovers and hangs on. Other than that, this period's going pretty darn well for the Lightning. It is now 4-2.
Steven Stamkos' line, he's got some moves. The Stamkos line's been good, but watch Stammer on his last time out. He's going to come in and stop up. But when he stops up, he should dish it right down into the corner. Look where Radish in the middle of the ice is going. All kinds of room in the corner there, but he ends up getting boxed out, turned over, 2-1-1. He's got a defenseman in foot moving up. Can't do that. You got to control the puck, be patient. He has made some great moves in this game. Steven Stamkos has, and he does have 3 points already. But when you want to control plays like that, get it deep.
Matthews swings at that puck. Simmons finished, and Vasilevsky made the save. Joseph is without a stick out there, and the Leafs have the puck. Austin Matthews with it, making some moves on Joseph with no stick. Little back and forth with Bunting, turns and fires. Puck is loose. Vasilevsky's down. He has got it as it rolls in on the Lightning net.
Austin Matthews is a smart man. I don't know why players don't do this more often. When you're against a player who doesn't have a stick, so many teams just seem to ignore the fact. What's the guy going to do? You can go right up to him. You can make all kinds of moves in front of him because he can't poke the puck off your stick. Use that time. Spin him around a couple of times. Matthews did that, and it created some havoc for the Lightning.
Face off to the right to Vasilevsky. Steven Stamkos with his 9th multi-point game. Lost the draw, that long range shot. Knocked down by Vasilevsky, and it comes to the board. Picked up now by Simmons. Bunting gets that one in deep. McDonough tied up Matthews. Simmons trying to jam it on the short side and could not. Now it's Bunting. Cycles it back, waiting for it is Austin Matthews, who seems to be out on the ice constantly tonight. Back to the point for Riley, in there looking for the tip. And Brody lifted it high, and now it's trapped and held by Vasilevsky with that long reach. He's got it over the back of his net.
Vasilevsky's even making saves backwards, coming back off the glass. That's how aware he is. He doesn't want this one to come back and hurt him. I thought maybe, or he was wondering too, did it go off the screen? No, but he realized it's off the glass. We've seen that happen before. Off the glass, off the top of the net, hit a goalie in the back and end up in the back of the net. So he's tracking the puck everywhere, even when it's behind him.
Tavares settles in there against Belmar, and they're going to redo this faceoff. Tavares waved out. I believe he won that with his hands. Threw it back to the point. And Nylander pulls it back to Tavares. To the line for Liljegren. His drive saved by Vasilevsky. Rebound into the corner. Perry up to boards. Tavares finds the open man, Muzzin. Muzzin back to Kerfoot. One-timer, and it hits the side of the net. Kerfoot cutting back on Belmar, leaves it for Nylander. His shot hits the side of the goal.
Victor Hedman's got a right-handed stick out there. He is the one who lost this stick. I think it was Corey Perry gave him a stick.
One timer on the way, and Vasilevsky's got that, and he'll hang on, and Hedman can go get a proper stick.
Kerfoot gets the scoring chance because, again, Toronto was very aware. This time, Victor Hedman had lost his stick. And so who's his man? Hedman's on Kerfoot. They make the diagonal pass, and Kerfoot is able to get a one-timer. If Hedman had had a stick, it probably wouldn't have happened. Left side of your screen, Toronto takes advantage. See right there, there's the shot for Kerfoot, and Corey Perry, even though it's a right-handed stick, it's better to have a wrong-handed one than none at all. Victor would have had a good backhand anyway.
Face-off win by Stamkos, ends up with Palat. Andre Palat, rink wide to Stamkos, takes a shot. Maybe looking for a tip there in front, and that is Riley Nash parked right in the blue paint.
Boy, Palat's having a heck of a game here tonight. He is on the puck everywhere.
And here he comes again on the forecheck, forcing Liljegren out from behind his own net. This one's worked across to Kasha, bounced away from him. Up ahead to Palat again, and back in they go. Puck goes back inside the Lightning blue line. McDonough to Bogosian. Bogosian near side for Andre Palat. Palat across, inside, trying to find Nash. Pass was in his skates. Here's Nylander. Nylander steps in, hangs on, toe drag. Never got a shot away. And it's taken away by Sergachev. Banked back, and Bunting heads back the other way for Toronto. Michael Bunting cuts across. To the feed one in, rebound for Tavares, and he can't get that puck to sit down. And now we get a little pushing and shoving here with Bunting and Tkachuk at the side of the net, but some good pushback by Toronto.
Lightning are in scramble mode here a couple of times because of the quick strike attack by the Toronto Maple Leafs, and the Lightning have to back in. Kerfoot did a heck of a job of literally fighting that rush off. Did a good job of breaking it up. The Leafs couldn't make the passes that they wanted to because Foot was able to jam the middle of the ice. But it has been messy for the Lightning.
Tavares pulls it back for Justin Hall. Throws one across the goal crease. And now it's picked up by Ross Colton. Colton, right side, takes it wide on Nylander, still with a puck on his stick all the way around the inch. Back to the line for Foot, loads, wrist shot, and a Campbell glove save ends that. 5:49 to go in the second period. It's 4-2, Tampa Bay on Valley. Guys, as in the bonus play getaway promotion, it's so much gift. The Florida Lottery, it's your ticket. Claim it. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly.
2021 has been a very good year for Andrei Vasilevsky. The last 2 years have, of course, because the Stanley Cup winner. But look at the calendar year wins. Marc-Andre Fleury in 09 was 62. Vasilevsky was 60 already, and still some time to go. It ain't over yet, 21. Bernie Perron winning the Stanley Cup, of course, has everything to do with that. Means you're going the distance and you have the most wins. So he's only two behind Marc-Andre Fleury. And today is only December 9th, so he's got a little room to work.
It really set the tone for this five-game road trip with a season-high 37 save win in Boston to help the Lightning really kind of steal one. And now here they are, 3-0 with a two-goal lead in game number 4 of this road trip. They'll wrap it up Saturday in Ottawa. Puck is back there somewhere, 5.5 to go. Hedman walks up from the boards, tries a slap shot, blocked by Kasha, and then makes the play to make sure that Kasha didn't take off.
One guy.
Good. In on Campbell. He'll knock this one into the corner for Brody. Kasha starts up the right side, stripped by Hedman. Belmar trying to find it, so is Victor Hedman. Almost came free for Maroon. Again, if you missed it, no Anthony Cirelli tonight. Out day to day with an upper body injury. And icing is the call there against Toronto. And now a word from Duncan.
It's time to get back in the game. And Duncan has you covered from late nights to early mornings. America runs on Duncan.
Defensemen on both teams really have to be aware. Both these teams are really good on transition, especially if you turn pucks over anywhere near blue lines. The weak side players, the weak side forwards are just blowing the zone. Their area passes, their speed coming at you. You got to sort it out if you're a D-man. You got to look around everywhere and read the speed.
Oh, there's a shot by Kasha. Engvall had lifted it in. That was going to be icy, but Kasha got there and got a shot away. Liljegren fans on that one, and here comes Palat trying to race away. Andre Palat got tangled up, and Muzzin cleared it. And that is blown down right to the blue line.
Well, Radish fitting in really nicely. Big goal on this line. It's a big chance for him playing with Steven Stamkos, one of the great players in the league, and Andre Palat, one of the great two-way players in the game. Tons of experience there, and what they'll say to him, I'm sure they did before the game, just play your game. You know what to do. Don't make a big deal of it. You get a chance to shoot, shoot the puck. And shoot, he did. He had two great chances and scored on one.
Three goals now in his last four games. In the corner, it's Austin Matthews trying to get away, banks it back to the point, moved across now to Liljegren. His shot, a weak one that's swept in by Simmons and now picked up by Colton. Colton, his bank attempt there, ends up at the lead bench, and we get another whistle. It's day five of Tampa Bay Sports, 16 days of winning. Today only, get this, men's Columbia polo for only $34.99. It's available online at TampaBaySports.com while supplies last. Use one-click checkout with FAST and stay tuned each day for more details.
You can tell John Cooper loves that Stamkos line too. They come right back out again, pretty almost double shifting. Not rolling four lines by any means is John Cooper at this point in the game.
Yeah, all three of them are really clicking tonight, aren't they?
Yeah.
Bringing lots to the table. Sergachev out from behind his net. Near side pass to Palat. Gets it up to center for Radish. Radish dumps it in. Stamkos up there on Riley, and he checks Riley hard at the end of that play. He finished it for sure. Here's Stamkos at center. He'll leave it. And it's dumped back in by Taylor Radish. Brody had to sidestep the forecheck. Now he's giving it up to Palat. Back to the point for Sergachev. His wrist shot in on Campbell. And Campbell has got that. No rebound.
That was Andre Palat again getting in there and disrupting and causing turnovers, using his feet. Watch this. Slick little move there with his feet, little soccer action. Back to Sergachev, and Sergachev with traffic in front, nothing fancy about that. The shots heavily in favor of the Leafs so far in this game, 26-18 in favor of the Leafs, but Sergachev getting one through, but Toronto defenseman had boxed out well, and Campbell's able to make that save easily.
Out comes Riley Nash with Tkachuk and Forche, and this draw is won by the Lightning and Nash. Tkachuk in the corner. Makes a strong play to get the puck back to the line. McDonough dumps it back in. Here's Nash. Nash checked by Rubens. Gets right back in the battle. Rubens checks him again. He is a load.
Oh, and Tkachuk with a big hit in the corner there, too. Ooh.
On Rubens. And there he is right there. Bogosian from his knees bats that puck away from a little bit of trouble developing, and now centering pass knocked aside by Vasilevsky. Picked up by McDonough, and the Lightning start back up the ice. Centering pass got away from him trying to find Forche. Muzzin dumps it right back down. 2.5 to go in the second period. Tampa Bay with four different goal scorers tonight. Two here in the second period. Liljegren backs up and then banks it up the boards. Matthews finds the open man. Muzzin trying to cut in, and that is going to be an offside call at the Bolts blue line.
High speed game, a lot of turnovers right now. The checking's more close than it has been at certain times in this game. The neutral ice area is so important in today's game, but it just seems to me particularly when these two teams play against each other, because their transition play is so good, they will use stretch pass, and boy, you turn it over near the blue lines and you're sunk.
Up along the boards there, knocked back in by Nylander. Radish plays it back to Victor Hedman. Hedman to Palat. And just over the line. Stamkos trying to dig that puck out from Nylander. And it's lifted back in. There is Vasilevsky, makes the play to Hedman. Hedman knocks it across to Ruda. Palat at center ice to Hedman. Onto the backhand and in. Morgan Rielly waits for the line change to complete, and now he starts out. Rielly right up onto the tape and off the tape of Richie. Joseph near side boards. Pinned there by Brody. It comes free. Here comes Colton. Colton in, wrist shot, and it rises on him over the shoulder of Campbell.
He's got a really good wrist shot. I don't think Campbell's seen it much.
We saw that right away when he showed up last year, didn't we?
Yeah. He surprised a couple of goaltenders.
Here comes Kasha. Kasha for the Leafs, trying to cut in on foot. Gets the puck back, can't center it. Into the final minute now of this second period. Icing is the call against Tampa Bay.
Yeah, Ross Colton can really snap the puck, and when he's on the rush especially, he really has good control. He's got a great release to it. This one, he just pulls. I don't know if that maybe got deflected by Morgan Rielly just at the last second. It flew right over the net, but it jumps off his blade, and that's something that catches, or maybe even Campbell might even have got a shoulder on that one, not quite sure. But he's got a really good release on the rush.
He lost that draw, though, here in the final minute. There's a shot, and you got to be careful here. They gave up a goal in the final minute of the first. They don't want it to happen again. Stay tuned for your local Honda dealer second intermission report. Here's what's coming up. Paul Kennedy and Bobby the Chief Taylor are standing by in the studio, and they will have an interview with Taylor Radish, who has scored his third goal of this season here in his hometown area. Highlights and stats, and they'll take you around the NHL as well.
Lightning have to plan on losing this draw.
And they lost it. Tavares pulls it back. Muzzin back in front. In behind everybody. Batted to the line. Not out. Matthews holds his ground. Here's Liljegren. Dumps it back in. Kerfoot giving a bump there by McDonough. In comes Tavares to help out. Kerfoot now. Pinned by Stamkos. Centering pass. Nobody home for Toronto. Over on the near side boards. Here's Matthews now with a wrist shot. That's blocked. Puck goes up in the air, and Kerfoot races over. 10 seconds to go here. Lots of lead pressure inside the blue line. Chopped at by Stamkos, and that will do it. So they weather a bit of a storm as the second period ends. And after 40, Steven Stamkos with his three-point night, and the Lightning have a two-goal lead. 4-2 here in Toronto. Day you've always wanted. It's your journey. Own it. Right now, the Lightning own a two-goal lead after 40 minutes of play here in downtown Toronto in the fourth of a five-game road trip. And the real story has been the line of Steven Stamkos, Andre Palat, and Taylor Radish.
Best line on the ice by far. They've had 21 shifts. John Cooper knows that they're going to. 40-second shifts, that's key. They keep it at high tempo. They're on the attack all the time. Steven Stamkos with that first period goal, what a beauty it was. They tracked the puck back really well. They turned pucks over. Andre Palat's been outstanding on the forecheck, and Steven Stamkos has got some kind of jump in this game. Moving pucks into the scoring area, a little bit of luck there, but the play was there. That was the key. Palat actually wanted to pass it, and it went in. And then how about that shot by Taylor Radish? These three guys, eight of the 18 shots that the Lightning have total have come from the Stamkos line, but even better, 7 points on the night combined for these three guys. We're going to see a lot more of them in the third period, too.
Taylor Radish put up on that line in the absence of Anthony Cirelli after they had to juggle some units up. They broke up a couple lines. The only one stayed together is the Pierre-Edouard Belmar line, and they've scored, too. So it's a good situation on the road here for the Lightning against a very good Leaf team.
And I got to say, I really like the look of Taylor Radish on that line. I mean, I think he could really go places here playing with these two guys, because he's got the hands of confidence is really coming now. He's scoring some goals, and he can really shoot.
So here we go, third period. Belmar's line starts for John Cooper, and they put the puck deep in. Go to work, grinding away, forcing the Leafs to come 200 feet. Out comes Morgan Rielly over his own blue line. Can't get it in. Jan Rutta knocks it down, clears it, comes back out to center for Belmar. Belmar up and head to Hedman. Hedman to Perry. Perry in, and he couldn't get the shot away around Morgan Rielly. Simmons resets and gets the puck back. Works it near side for Morgan Rielly. There is Stamkos swirling around. Lead pass up ahead to Kerfoot. Kerfoot is into the backhand. Stopped by Vasilevsky. Here's Nylander. His drive and a shot block right in front. That was Palat. Both Palat and Stamkos sold out of that play. Against the guy who's got a goal in this game and one of the sharper shooters of the NHL. Here's Radish trying to go back and forth with Stamkos. Broken up by Muzzin. Puck stays in the corner. Now it's gathered by Liljegren. Kicked back to Jake Muzzin. Nylander gets it back from Tavares. He is forced all the way back. Long pass up the ice for Kerfoot, who just had that great chance. He's going to throw it back at his netminder while they all reset.
Lightning needs some more shots on goal, even if they come from Toronto. That's all right.
Kasha cuts across the middle, up high in the zone. Here's Kasha. The open to Hall. All around the net, looking for a target. Out in front of that pass. Just got right through Richie. Richie in the corner, back out in front. It comes to Foote. Foote goes up and out, down the ice. Joseph trying to barge his way in there on Hall. Almost went outside in on him. Stays in the battle with the puck. Sends it inside for Colton. Colton down low now for Alex Killorn. Walks out, centers it, and just out of the reach of Joseph. Here's Joseph again. Tripped up, penalty call coming up here. Campbell's got the puck. And the Lightning are going to get a power play as Rubens is going to be headed to the box.
Yeah, going to be a tripping call here. And Toronto getting feisty in front of their own net. That was Justin Hall who popped Ross Colton pretty good in the face. I don't think he's going to get a penalty for that. But the original tripping call will be called on Christians Rubens.
56 Toronto, 2 minutes tripping.
Lightning all around the net, putting pressure on, and when you put pressure on consistently, you move your feet. There's the tripping call by Rubens.
So Tampa Bay with another power play opportunity. They've got a power play goal tonight from Stamkos, and he is going to take the draw. That's the one thing that's not going well for Stamkos tonight, the faceoffs, but he's doing everything else. He's even got four hits in this game. And they lost that draw. This one's in the corner. And it's knocked down the ice by the Leafs. Victor Hedman picks up the puck and starts out. Hedman through center, throws it in there. Campbell watching that one all the way, and the Lightning trying to set things up. Walking out is Palat, and he couldn't turn and shoot as he was stripped of the puck by Muzzin. Muzzin up the ice. He's got Nylander. Open Nylander. Fires it wide. They stay on the play, and Vasilevsky hugs that post on Muzzin with a second opportunity. What a chance for Nylander. Off the skates there of Radish. Hedman throws this one across, knocked down by Killorn. Killorn puts it to the sideboards, and this is an unorganized entry, and it goes all the way back down the ice.
A lot of times when you give up a shorthanded chance, especially the one as good as they gave to Nylander, it throws your power play off. You're just as well to get, you know, get a line change, get the next group up.
Well, they dodged a bullet there.
Yeah.
That really could have changed the complexion of this game early in the third period, but it stays a two-goal lead, 41 seconds to go in the power play. Lead pass up ahead to Perry. Perry puts it across, trying to find Sergachev, and he does, but he had to reach back for it, and Engvall came in. Now Perry, open wide, shoots, saved by Campbell. Big save there by Jack Campbell.
Good job by Sergachev along the wall to keep that play alive. It was a 50-50 puck for Toronto to get out of the zone and ice it down, but it was Sergachev who kept it alive and got it to Corey Perry in lots of room.
Stamkos picks his way to the zone. worked back towards the net for Toronto, and now skating out at center is Liljegren. Power play is now over. Rubin steps out of the box. Team's back to 5-on-5. 4.5 into this third period. Slapped in by Hedman. Campbell's going to hang on for a faceoff coming up to his right.
Toronto got an excellent scoring chance, and it was Andre Palat coming out from behind the net, and he's under a lot of pressure. He wants the loop, and he falls down. Now, here we go. That gives the scoring chance, and Toronto does a heck of a job there keeping that play alive coming up the ice, which allowed the one-on-one chance, but it missed the net. And then Corey Perry, there's the chance that he got all alone in time, and he got lots of wood on that one.
Faceoff won by Riley Nash, pulled it back. Bogosian sends it back in deep. Nash up in the play. Come free for Simmons. Now to the line, it's McDonough. Here's Bogosian. He looks and fires right on. Campbell stopped that, and the rebound popped right out. Michael Bunting cuts back and gives it to Christian Rubens. Kicks that one into the corner for Hall. Hall having trouble up front there with Gabriel Forche in his back pocket the entire play there. And he's forced back. Hall is going to leave it now for Morgan Riley. Riley skates this one to center and fires a snapshot in. Hedman in the corner. Missed the mark, and this is going to be icing against the Lightning.
We talk about milestones all the time for the players, so we like to congratulate Mike Poirier, the athletic trainer for the Lightning. This is game number 1500 for him. It is amazing what athletic trainers and the equipment trainers go through. Some really thankless hours, and a lot of stuff goes on behind the scenes. A very talented athletic trainer is Mike, and 1500, that's a nice big round number. Congrats.
Indeed, Mike, congratulations on a major milestone, and you're right, the hours these guys put in. I can barely pack my suitcase for a road trip. Colton takes the shot, a rebound pops out. These guys got to pack a whole hockey team. Here's Kasha, puts it to the open side. And it's pushed up ahead by Ronnie. Here's Tavares, now steps in. Tavares shoots, saved by Vasilevskiy as he stares down the Leaf captain. They continue to battle for the puck. Kasha from his knees gets up on the play. And it comes along the sideboards. Tavares, like many Leafs, coming in hot with 11 points in his last 7. Scored in the last game. He had a great chance right there. And Vassy stops him. Tipped on the way through. Sent hard around the boards. Foot arrives, bumps Bunting, and jars that puck free. Now Bunting on the backside, leaves it for Nylander. Nylander dancing into the backhand, sweeps it across. That's broken up by Palat and cleared.
Palat's been in the right place every time in this game, whether it's offensively or defensively.
Right here, Willie.
Nylander again steps in. He'll leave it for Muzzin. Muzzin trying to go back door to Bunting. Didn't get there cleanly, but he works it back to the point. Sent back around near side boards. Foot chops at that. That is gathered up by Sergachev. Up ahead to Belmar. Pad Maroon. Off his skates to his stick, and the puck stays deep. Perry's up there, so is Belmar. And now the Leafs have the puck. Rolling back away, here is Ryan McDonough. He'll back this one off the far boards, cut off by Steves. Up ahead to Kyle Clifford. And back in it goes. Perry tries a long pass, looking for Maroon. Perry was slow to get up after a big hit along the side wall. And now he goes right back after the man who delivered the hit, Rubens. Rubens has been a menace tonight.
Yeah, he has. He's got under the skin of a lot of Lightning players. Lightning have run at him, too.
Here's another hit by Rubens. That one on Forche. Here's Hedman. Hedman dumps it in. Nash gets it to Forche. Forche lost his balance, and it's picked up and taken away by David Kamp. Kamp trying to work it up the wall. Kerfoot was forced back. Now the bodies are flying. Boris Kachuka's getting into the act.
He has been all night. He's thrown some big hits.
Ian Ross Colton the team leaders in hits. Kachuk might be the leader after tonight.
He's got a nasty edge to him, Boris Kachuk does.
Sergachev checks his shoulder. Works it near side to Jan Rutta. Up to center. Picked up now on the fly by Colton. Colton skates into that one. Ran out of room as he was angled off there by TJ Brody. Now Brody's got the puck and works it up the ice. Just lifts this one in into the corner. Nick Ritchie. Sergachev on him. Centering pass, and that's blocked by Colton. And it ends up going outside the line. Joseph lost his stick on the play. Heads to the bench as the Leafs dump it right back in. Tavares in towards the goal. Puck at the feet. Ritchie can't find it. Now Nick Ritchie in the corner to Tavares. Back up top to Muzzin. Muzzin, his shot. Lays down for Tavares. That's blocked by Foote. Kasha given a shove there by Sergachev. Drive saved by Vasilevsky. Saw it at the last second. Foote hustling after that one. Chopped at. And now Tavares with some room walks out, finds Muzzin. He shoots, saved by Vasilevsky. Rebound, they score! Vasilevsky thought he had it. It came free, and Andrei Kasha gets his second of the night, and it's a one-goal game.
Too bad for Vasilevsky because he made a great save here. Came out and really challenged on the shot from the point. And then watch Sergachev in front of the net. He stops for a second. He thinks the play is over. He doesn't realize that the puck is on the other side of Vasilevsky. I think, yeah, Sergei let up for a second. See that? He thought his goaltender had it, and then he went, oh, no, are you kidding? Kasha sniffing around there, realized that the puck had dropped out, and he gets a freebie.
26-year-old Andrei Kasha, a goal in the last game. Two goals here tonight. This is a guy who played just three games last year. Had an upper body injury. Three games with Boston. They picked him up. Free agent signing in Toronto. And that is now goal number 8 for him already. So it is 4-3 at the midway point of this third period. Did you think it was going to be any different here tonight? Not with these two. Over the last 20 games, you're looking at the top two teams in the NHL. And here comes Riley, centering pass, trying to find Nylander. And the pass was too high in the air to knock down.
Belmar shaking up there, I think. Went into the boards pretty heavily.
9:56 to go in the third period. Andrei Kasha has made it 4-3. We're in for a good finish tonight in Toronto on Bally Sports.
Canada at the Olympics, and he was asked today by the Toronto press, do you get a chance to really watch players on the opposition and evaluate them, because of course they have to pick the team? And there's one guy, you know, that Toronto press was thinking about. John Tavares has played for Team Canada before. He is having a heck of a season again as well, and I'm sure he wants it every bit as much as his buddy that he grew up with, Steven Stamkos. Now for Coop, obviously he sees Stammer all year long, and Stammer's having a heck of a year and a heck of a game, but so is John Tavares. But Coop said, you know what, I'm busy coaching a game, I'm trying to win a game, so I can't really evaluate. I can say I can evaluate players on the opposition, but he said when I rewatch the game, of course I have that in the back of my mind.
Right now he's just trying to steer this one home, as his players have built a 2-goal lead, now down to 1. Half the third period remaining here on the road. And it's going to be an icing call against Tampa Bay. So the star of the show right now for Tampa Bay is Steven Stamkos. We've talked about how he loves coming home. How about this is his 5th career 3-point game against the Leafs. 4 of them have been in this rink. And oh, by the way, he's at 897 career points. 3 away from 900. Puck is dug free for Belmar. Belmar at center, banks it up ahead just out of the reach of Pilat. Brody checks the clock as he skates up the ice and drops it back. Right into it is Morgan Riley. He's at center and picking his way to the zone. Here comes Riley. Takes the puck wide. Fires a shot wide of the net. It's met by Bunting and into the corner. Hedman tries to chip it past Bunting, and he does. And here comes Killorn. Killorn steps in over the blue line, and that is going to be an offside call. Well, here's tonight's Road Ahead, brought to you by Toyota.
After this game, the Lightning will head to Ottawa, and that will finish off this five-game road trip. It'll be an afternoon affair on Saturday in Ottawa, and then they'll go home right after that game. Los Angeles Kings and Ottawa, that'll be back home.
Not many home games remaining in the month of December, no, in the holiday season at Amalie Arena. So those will be two good ones for sure. Festive atmosphere. Belmar trying to force his way up, and he's drawn a penalty here. The Lightning are going to get another power play and a careless penalty by Andre Kotchu, who's got two goals, and now he's going to have to sit in the box and hope that his team
Toronto
can
number 25.
Kill this thing off. Hooking. He's going for hooking, and we are going for a break. When we come back, Lightning power play, 4-3.
He's explaining to the timekeeper, I didn't really do it. He's pleading insanity, but when you reach in like this in today's game, you're anywhere near a guy's hands and you're behind him, you're going to get called for hooking. And that's what the call was on him here. So big chance for the Lightning to stretch this lead up by one, and they're on the power play.
Third power play of the night, and Stamkos with a big face-off win. They set things up right off the draw. Hedman walks the line, kicks it back to Pelot. Pelot steps in, snaps a shot, rebound, and they can't find the puck. Toronto does, and down it goes.
I don't think Andre Pelot realized how much time and room he had when he initially got that pass. I think he had a predetermined idea in his mind what he wanted. Boy, two steps into the middle, he could have ripped it.
Good pass up ahead, almost connected with Pelot. Puck goes into the corner, here's Radish. Nice move to work it back to the line, and it hopped over the stick of Stamkos. Vasilevsky threw this one up the boards. Almost right up to Kerfoot, it was taken away from him. Now Pelot inside the blue line, centering pass to Killorn. Backdoor pass in front for Radish, and it was in his skates. Lightning come close there. Radish reaching for that puck. Killorn to Pelot, to Hedman. Here's Stamkos with a shot, and it's wide of the net. Rebound collected by Pelot into the middle. Hops up in the air. In comes Killorn, but it's found by Muzzin, and out it goes.
Steven Stamkos is amazing. Even on the worst angles possible, he just always knows instinctively where that net is. He can drift down to the bottom of the circle or up to the top of the circle. He doesn't miss.
Fired in, Brody plays it back. It's kicked back to the point. McDonough to Pat Maroon. Maroon tried a cheeky little saucer pass. That's knocked down, and out comes Riley. Riley's got Nylander up on the play. Remember, Nylander had that great shorthanded breakaway earlier in this period.
Yeah.
McDonough. Miscommunication. There's Kerfoot again, who's causing problems on this penalty kill with Toronto. Kick back to Vasilevsky. Off the glass and out. And that does it. Kasha is out of the box. And it stays a one-goal game with 6:47 remaining here in regulation. Tampa Bay being outshot 34-23 overall. But on the scoreboard, up by one, dumped in by Nash. Forechase up there, so is Kachuk. Puck comes free in the near side corner. Richie reaches for it, they get it free to Kasha. Kasha pulls that back and then starts out. Two goals of the night for this guy. Puts it up ahead to Richie, little give and go back to Kasha and out of his reach. Knocked away by Hedman. Hedman makes the play, puts it up the boards, chopping at it is Kachuk, Leafs get it back. And this one's going to pull everybody out. 6 minutes to go. Watch Sheldon Keefe. How soon before he really loads up that big line again? Done it a couple of times tonight. Radish in over the blue line. And that one goes up and out of play. 5:47 remaining here in the third period. Lightning by one.
Has a goal and assist. He almost had another goal. Really good sequence again by the Stamkos line. Starts by Pelot. cross ice pass, and then the real quickie from Stamkos right into the middle. But Radish, I'm not sure he was ready for it to come so quickly, but it was in his feet anyway. But he's got his stick down, he gets ready, he's in the scoring areas. That Stamkos line continues to do some terrific things.
Tell you what, it's been impressive how this team just fills holes. Already without Kucherov, Braden Point, they lose Eric Chernak. Now tonight they're without Anthony Cirelli, and here they are up by one on the road in Toronto. Richie trying to take a shot, could not get it through. Back to the point, Ronnie wide open there, faking the shot was Brody. His stick broke on him, and now it's Stamkos who gets the puck and gives the outlet to Palat, and back in it goes. Brody's back in position with a new stick. Brody makes the play, gets it free, and now it's turned over. Here's a chance, Radish back to Palat, and a save made. Jack Campbell with a big stop there. Ruda puts it across. Hedman settles it down, goes back to Ruda. Ruda into the corner. Andre Palat in towards the net. Joseph's going to get after the puck. It comes free for Morgan Riley. Banks this one up ahead. Ruda knocks it away from Tavares, and now here comes Joseph with a lane. Matthew Joseph stops, shoots, kick, saved by Campbell. He's been a couple here. Giving his team a chance. He's done that a lot this season. Another turnover. Joseph drops it off. Colon in. Saved by Campbell. Another kick save and a beauty. Back to the Wickham. Bunting. His shot goes high on Vasilevsky. Chances at either end here with just over 4 minutes left of the clock.
Boy, some huge saves. Campbell really looks sharp. I mean, he's been like this all season long. He's under control. He's not making the first move, and that's been key to a lot of these leg saves.
Forche trying to barge his way in, knocked down by Nash, comes to the line. There's Bogosian, bats it forward. Boris Kachuk gets after it. Kachuk in the corner, Nash supporting. And they make the play back. Liljegren is going to bank this off the boards. Stays inside the line. Leafs get a hold of it again. There's Matthews. Lead pass up ahead to Simmons. Simmons is forced back. Tampa Bay really shutting things down, keeping a lot of the play down here now. 3.5 to go. Kerfoot tries to step in, takes it wide, centers it across, and it's into the glove of Vasilevsky. Keeps the play moving.
Smart, because Toronto's been so good in the faceoff, he doesn't want another faceoff inside his zone. Vasilevsky kept it moving.
And his teammates give him some help to get the puck back and get it outside the line. Swept back in. Hall's going to hustle because here comes Perry and Maroon. Maroon gets onto the puck, into the corner, and now David Kamp with it. To Kasha, makes one move at center ice, leaves it for Kerfoot. Long range wrist shot. That's an easy stop for Vasilevsky. McDonough off the boards. Here's Tavares in front, and Kasha was wide open, and it was poked away from him.
Nice job by Sergachev, recognizing that Kasha was alone and ready for a big one-timer there from a great A spot. Nice play by Sergachev.
John Tavares puts it back into his own zone. Riley, nice little play to get away from Andre Palat. Lead pass up to Richie. Richie, his shot kicked out by Vasilevsky. Rebound into the corner. Try to feed it out front to Tavares. That's cut off, and here comes Colton back the other way. Colton inside. He'll head for the front of the net, and it is offside at the Maple Leaf blue line.
That was Joseph that went offside just by a hair on this last rush, and Joseph has had a really good scoring chance as well. And a line change for Toronto. You see them come busting over as quick as they can. He makes a good shot off the far pad. And then Alex Killorn, after a terrific play by Hedman at the blue line and a heads-up play by Joseph to bunt it back by Killorn. And another huge save by Campbell. And then Vasilevsky keeping the play moving, as I was talking about. They don't want to have too many faceoffs in their own zone. They're still getting smoked in the faceoff circle.
Liljegren. The outlet pass to Muzzin. Muzzin at center. Caught up to that puck and dumps it in. Trails after it against McDonough. Now it's in the opposite corner. There's Muzzin again getting it to Nylander. Nylander controls it, and Campbell gets the call. Here's Liljegren with a shot. Extra attacker comes over the boards for the Leafs with 1:50 remaining. Matthews with the puck, banks it back, and Tavares hustles in there to hold it inside the line. All the big guys on the ice for Toronto now. Matthews to Muzzin, across the Nylander, his shot saved by Vasilevsky, rebound cleared down, and this is going to miss the net by a wide margin. Crowd obviously looking for an icing call there. Puck goes into the corner. 1:18 to go. Matthews is digging for it. They find it. Get it back to Riley. Riley walks the line. Gives it up to Matthews. Banks off the end boards. Nylander trying to center it. Tavares can't get it to Nylander. Great play by Hedman. Trapped by Riley. His shot tipped by Kasha. High off the glass. Picked up by Bunting. In the corner. Final minute here in Toronto tonight. Lifted down the ice by the Lightning. This one's headed to the net. And Riley gets there just in time. 47 seconds left. Backed up to Matthews. He's double teamed, but gets the puck in. Kerfoot races after it. Trying to center it. Can't. Kalorn's right there. Comes free. Here's a chance to bank it into the empty goal. Kalorn off the ice. Alex Kalorn on the backhand. Stamkos in front. Tapped in. That will do it. An empty net goal for Andre Palat with 28 seconds on the clock, and it's 5-3.
Well, this is a fitting goal for Andre Palat to end up having this one, a slam dunk right from the edge of the paint. Beautiful, unselfish play here, both by Kalorn and then Steven Stamkos, so easily could have shot it into the empty net. But Palat makes sure he gets right to the paint. Stammer gives it to him, and they dish it off. 4 points for Steven Stamkos. That's three for Andre Palat, and the Lightning do a good job with the goaltender pulled. We've seen a lot of goalies pulled around the NHL, and actually a Sheldon Keefe, I thought, was kind of conservative. A little less than 2 minutes to go, and he finally pulled his goaltender. We're seeing goalies pulled with 3 and 4 and even sometimes 5 minutes to go in games. That's usually with when you're 2 goals down, but hey, we've seen a lot of it, and a lot of teams are effective. Minnesota's got 8 6-on-5 goals so far this year already.
Steven Stamkos, as you mentioned, up to 4 points, including career point number 898. Final seconds ticking away as the Tampa Bay Lightning are going to improve to a perfect 4-0 on this road trip. And congratulations to the head coach, John Cooper, who becomes the fastest coach in NHL history to 400 wins. 5-3 is the final. Here's the Ackerman Jewelers Diamond Performance.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt. Steven Stamkos just had one heck of a night. Brilliant stuff, including that shot on a rolling puck that just the goaltender didn't even see. Dishing the puck off all over the place. A beautiful little play into the middle there to Palat, who ends up with a goal. He dished another one right into the slot for the kid Radish to fill the top of the net too, and then he paid it off with an empty net assist to Andre Palat.
The Lightning come into Toronto and get it done, and they keep on winning. This is now a season high 5-game win streak. 4-0 roll on the road. Ottawa is next on Saturday, all highlighted by the 4-point game by Stamkos. Don't forget Lightning Live post game coming up, brought to you by Advent Health. On behalf of Brian Engblom, this is Dave Randorf saying thanks for watching, everybody. Talk to you Saturday from Ottawa.